So let's go ahead and do this example. This will be the data that I'm inserting in order. 5, 10, 15, 6, 9, 7, 11, 4, and 12. And I'm inserting this into an initially empty splay tree. So I start with the 5. That's the new node that I insert, and that's at the root, so there's no problem. Next node I'm going to insert is the 10. So there's my new node X, and we can see that it's the child of the root, so I just do a simple rotation, single rotation. So there's my new node X at the root level. Okay, now I'm going to insert a 15. 15 is greater than 10, and we can see I've got my new node is the child of the root, so I just do a single rotate around that link right there, and I have 15, 10, 5, where the 15 is now up there at the root level. Okay, next I will have, let me redraw the tree here, 15, 10, and 5. Next node I insert, next value will be a 6, like so. Okay, I have here the zigzag structure, so I do the AVL rotation. So first I will rotate around this. This is my X value right there. So first I'll rotate around that. So I have 15, 10, and then 6 and 5. And then I rotate around this link right here. So I'll rotate right around that link. So I have 15, 6, 10, and the 5 right there. And here is the new node that I have inserted, so I'm not done yet. I have to rotate around my next level up, and that's the root, so it's a single rotation. So there's my new node X rotated up to the root level, and then I have, like so. There we go. So that takes care of my 6 insertion. Now I have to insert the 9, so 6, 15, 10. 9 with the 5, and here's my new value. So I clearly have a zigzag, so I will do that double rotation splay tree style. First rotate around this link right here, and then around this link right here. So that's going to give me the 6, 9, 10, and 15. You can do it step by step to make sure it's okay. And so my new node, my X node, is right there. I'm not done yet. I have to rotate the 9 up to the root level. So 9 and 6, like so. There's my new node. 10 and 5, my new node is at the root, so that's, I'm done. Okay, next node I'll be inserting will be the 7. Let me redraw my tree. Okay, so I'm inserting 7, and the 7 will go right here. I can see I have a zigzag structure right here, so I'll need to first rotate around, it's AVL rotation, so first I rotate around that link, and then I rotate around that link. So my first step will give me 9 with its new child 7, pushing down the 6, and also pushes down the 5, and then we have the 10 and 15 that are getting dragged along. Okay, so that's the first step, and then the second step is to rotate around the 9 and its child, so around this link right here. So the 7 is up at the top, pushing down the 9, dragging along the 6 and 5. Okay, now the node I just inserted was the 7, so I am done at that point. I'm going to continue this. Well, I think I can probably just grab this and continue this on a new page, huh? I better go back to the previous page, because I've already forgotten what my data will be that I need to get. So let's grab that data right there. Okay, so I am up to the, I've just finished the 7, time to insert the 11. So to insert the 11, let's redraw this. Well, this tree's fine right here. I'm going to insert the 11, so 7 greater than 9, greater than 10, less than 15. So there's the 11. I have here a zigzag, so that means first I rotate AVL rotation first around this link and then around this link. So that will give me the 7, 9, and then that will give me the 10, and then the 11 got rotated up, and 15, the 7, and its child 6 and 5 remain the same, and then I need to rotate around this link right here. That's my second rotation right there. So that gives me the 7, 9, and 11, dragging along the 15 and pushing the 10 down. And 6 and 5. Okay, the node I'm working on, it's the 11, is the one that I just inserted, and we see we have a ways to go here. I have a zigzag construct right there. So with the zigzag construct, well, I could do, here, I need to rotate around that link first and then this link second. So I'll have the 9 pushing down the 7, 6 and 5, and then dragging up with it the 11. Okay, then I need to rotate around this link right here. That's the number 2 link right there. So that pushes my 11 up to the top, pushing down the 9, 6, 5, and then, let's see, 10 goes there and 15 here. And now my 11 is up here at the root. So I've got a tree right there, splay tree right there. Okay, next thing to insert is the 4. So 11, 9, 15, 10, 7, 6, 5. 4 goes right there. Okay, I can see I have a zigzag. Okay, 7. And then here I'll have the 4, 5, and the 6. That's for my zigzag. 4 is moved up. Here I have another zigzag right here. Let's see if I have enough room to do this. 11 with the 4, 7, and 9 like so. 15, no change there. Push down the 10 from the 9. Okay, and I have the 5 and 6 coming off of the 7. Okay. So there's my 4, and I see I have still a single rotation that I have to do right there to give me my final tree with the 4 at the root, pushing down the 11 and the 15. Let's see, and then I've got my 7. Greater than 4, less than 11 is my 7, and then everything else just gets dragged along. Okay, so there's my new tree, my new splay tree right there with the 4. Moved all the way up to the root level. Let me grab a copy of that and put it on the next page. Okay, and I'll go back and grab my data. Okay, so I only have one value left to insert. That's the 2, the 12. So let me go ahead and put that in. There's 12. Let's see, 12 is greater than 4, is greater than 15, is greater than 11, is less than 15. So there's where my 12 goes. Not there, that would have been wrong right there. Okay, so there's my 12. I have here, I'm going to change color to make it easier to see. I have here a zigzag construct. So AVL rotation, first this one and then this one. Let me just do this part of the tree by itself. So I've got 11 with 12 and 15 like so, and then I do this rotation right here. So 12 has the two children, 11 and 15. Okay, so now let me put that into the tree at this point right here. So 4 has its right child 12, with the 11 and 15, like so. And then the 11 pushed down the 7, and then the rest of the tree remains the same. Oops, 6, like there. 9, 10. Okay, so I'm not quite done yet. The node I just inserted was the 12, and that needs to get moved all the way up to the root. I see I just have a single rotation right there. Well, let me draw the box around it so that you can see it. So I just have a single rotation right there. That should be easy enough. So 12 pushes down the 4, and greater than 12 is the 15, and then 11 is less than the 12 but greater than the 4, so everything else gets dragged along. Okay, and here is my final splay tree after inserting all that data.